Hello, everybody. This is Robbie, and today we're going to be playing the Ruff Ruffman Show games. And now, this show and I have long history. Basically, I grew up watching Fetch with Ruff Ruffman, and I really liked it. It was a great show. It was a great show, and I really, really liked it. Now, if you don't know what Fetch with Ruff Ruffman is basically. It's a PBS Kids game show. The host is an animated talking dog named Ruff Ruffman. Now the show had 5 seasons, and in season 2 and onwards, Ruff Ruffman would have a cat partner. Named Princess Betty, I guess. I'm not sure. But anyway, in each season, there would be 6 kids, and Ruff Ruffman had the studio with a television monitor to talk to the kids, and yeah, so there'd be 6 kids in a season, and some of the kids, or all of them, would go and do tasks, or one task or something. Like in the first episode of this show, the kids had to go to they had to learn the planets and how far away they were and create an accurate thing, well, as accurate as they could on Earth, depicting them like a scale model. And there was another one where they kind of worked at a food factory, and another one that where they did bacteria, as in like how there's bacteria on something. And there was other one, and there was another one where I could go on, but whatever. Basically, in the show. Oh, and with the 6 kids, well, sometime I'm like a select few would go. Like for example, 4 of them do this, and 2 of them stay in the studio, or 2 of them do this, and 4 of them stay in the studio. Oh, so yeah, and you can watch both. And Ruff Ruffman makes witty commentary throughout all of it, and basically, to make things, and basically because it wouldn't be fair if the kids who stayed in the studios didn't get any points. Oh yeah, there's a point system, and basically you get points for doing things in the show, like certain tasks correctly. And there was a leaderboard, and they recap how many points each person has at the start of every episode. Oh, just to catch you up in case you forgot. They don't recap the episode itself, they just tell you the point tally. Okay, so anyway, it was Ruff Ruffman, and so to make things feel fair, the kids at the studio, halfway through the show, got to answer, qu oh, would answer questions about what had happened in the show. And they would get 5 points per correct answer to make things feel fair, so that, no one could have the advantage. And yeah, it was really great and nice, and I really liked it. And then there was this fin and then there was always a finale where a winner was decided, and then we'd go on the Hall of Fame. And at the end of each episode, there'd be a prize for the winner of the show. And, oh, like sometimes the kids would be split into teams. Sometimes they'd all go, so there wouldn't be a quiz thing. Anywho, I'm getting ahead of myself. Oh, so there would be prizes at the end. You could get prize A or prize B. Basically, you feel like you win something. And then at the end of the entire thing, you could go into, and there was a grand finale. All 6 kids compete. And if you lose, don't worry. You get to watch from the comfort of a lounge somewhere in the studio. So there, that's a fit. Oh, so yeah. And besides, if you won before, you keep all the prizes and stuff. And I think there are consolation prizes too. Anywho, the winner of the entire thing gets put up on the Wall of Fame and gets a prize. I forget what it is. Oh God, I spent a long time talking about it. So yeah, I really like this show. And now it's called the Ruff Ruffman Show? Who are the hamsters? Team Hamster? What? Oh, this hamster's stuck on an infinite loop. Anywho, I'm so sorry about that. I just really like this show, Fetch with Ruff Ruffman. It was really great. It was experimental for PBS, but they did it right. Anywho, if you like this video, like it, subscribe to the channel,
Activities.
hit the notification bell and to be notified about my latest videos. And I don't know who the hamsters are. You know, there was a kind of spin-off show called Ruff of Media. Never watched that. Okay, anywho. So, first off is Splash Dash with the hamsters. Who are the hamsters? Team Hamster and the Ruff Ruffman Show. What? Yeah.
It didn't work. Water is headed for the comic books. To make the water flow in a different direction, we have to put something in its way.
Okay.
Oh, how about this bookend?
And this stapler.
Let's try it.
And hurry. The comic books are depending on us.
It's working. We saved them.
Uh-oh. Another leak. Can you help us?
That was actually good. You know, I actually thought that they added new characters just for stuff, so whatever, but that was kind of good. That's refreshing. Usually when you add new characters to a show, it just comes off as desperate. But whatever. They're not annoying, I like them. Okay.
Ruffy pulls water down. We can change the direction water flows by putting tools into the water's path.
Okay.
That will stop it from flowing straight down.
Can you save the comic books from getting wet? Try to move the water out of the window using the tools.
Use the arrow button.
Get the water to spin all the stars. That will unlock new pool toys.
Okay.
All right. You got all three stars.
Gotcha. Lovely. That's pretty good.
How could we solve this? Thanks for your help.
No problem. I think you can handle it from here, because I need to do other games! Oh, I almost forgot to mention! Okay, I'm sorry for rambling on again, but just Ruff's family! Who I think were all voiced by the same person, but whatever. There was Ruff's grandma, Ruff's, I think, younger brother, Lance, who was really into knights and stuff. And there's a bad brother named whatever, I don't know. But whatever, I just remember it all. It's like nostalgia just flows into me. Yeah, like, I highly recommend you watch this show. I highly recommend that you watch Fetch with Ruff Ruffman. Even the theme song is good. It's like Fetch da 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 da, da with Ruff Ruffman. It's so catchy and I love it. And PBS did a really good job with it. And oh my god, I'm just geeking out. I'm such a fan of the show. Oh, I love it. What was that? What is happening? Oh no, we can't handle it. Uh-oh. I think we crashed the... What?
Oh no, Ruff messed up all the...
What, they look fine to me. This cutscene is barely holding it together, and you're worried about the paintings? Ah, why is the cutscene just struggling like this? It's like, come on. It's like it's trying to start an engine. It's like, come on, come on. Like, those getaway scenes. And it's like, and it's like they're struggling to start it. And they're struggling to keep it going. And I think the cutscene is just dead at this point. Let's move on.
Let's fix some art together. Tap here.
Gotcha. Please don't die.
How can we use gears to help us draw circles?
I sketched an idea.
Okay, so I guess the blue hamster is the smart one. And I guess his catchphrase is, I sketched an idea.
Let's test out the gears by trying to draw a circle. First, choose a color.
Yeah!
You drew a tap the back button to keep...
Cool idea! Gears are great for drawing circles!
Did you just compliment... yourself? Okay.
With the pot!
Gotcha, 12 minutes in and we've only done 2 games! Because nostalgia. Again, highly recommend the show. Like, I'll play the theme song at the end of this.
Our favorite things. Ruff's gonna throw them all out.
Not if we get to the trash bins first.
Although... I don't like the way Ruff is portrayed in this. I mean, as in this. Like, it's like here... Okay, so, my problem is that here... Okay. In Fetch with Ruff Ruffman, Ruff is competent. And stuff like creating challenges for everybody. Making it all fair. Error two. And error. He can be a little bit stupid. Just a little bit. But then again, that comes to unpredictability and stress, probably. And so. Oh, yeah, anywho, but here, Ruff is just portrayed as oblivious. It's like, oh, I just put this rubber ducky in here. That fixed the problem. Off I go to, you know, just not focus on this. And then here, it's like, oh, sweeping, 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 sweeping. Doesn't even notice the favorite toys I knocked into the dusting bin. Sweeping. Like, just here he's portrayed as incompetent and oblivious when he wasn't before. But then again, is it just to make Sadie, Tasha, and Mateo, those are their names, I just saw them, the main characters? Because Ruff Ruffman is fine as a main character. Whatever. It's fine. It's all fine. We'll fetch with Ruff Ruffman is good. This... It's just a little problem, anywho.
Mateo! Time to rock and roll!
Gotcha.
Let's find our favorite thing!
Gotcha.
Move the hamster ball by dragging it, or use the left and right arrows on your keyboard.
Gotcha. Gotcha. Lovely.
Let's try the next
one more.
What do you think that is? A lever is a simple machine.
No, that's a seesaw. There we go. Don't know why that didn't register.
Whoa, that's sticky. You're so clever with levers.
Lovely. I feel like the majority of this video is me just fan geeking about the show and talking about that of than just me playing the games. But then again, Ruffman is a great show. Now then, please tell me Ruffman isn't incompetent this time.
It's cookie time! We're making cookies!
Okay, this feels...
Let's make some cookies! FDM Chet has helped us start by adding...
Oh, okay, the name was Chet!
...ingredients to make your cookie dough. Drag ingredients from the kitchen counter to the bowl. Make as many different cookies as you can. We will serve them to customers later.
Okay, two.
The numbers on the recipe card.
Okay, two of everything.
To start mixing your cookie dough, or you can keep adding more ingredients.
Yeah, we just kind.
What will happen when you mix the? Doing some mixing. What will happen when you cook the dough? Think about 5 minutes, 10 minutes. If I'm hungry, why do I have to wait?
I don't know.
The dough got hot and turned into a cookie. Let's look at what you've made. This cookie feels hard, tastes slightly salty, and it looks light brown. Let's save it to our recipe book so we can make it the same way again.
Okay.
A velvety malark. Tap an arom. A creamy lunker. An aromatic squeak. A velvety. Let's make a different cookie.
Okay, what happens if...
Eggs. Butter. Butter helps make the cookie soft or chewy. Sugar. Salt.
Okay, just one more.
Mixing it up. Da-da-da-da-da-da.
Oh my god, this is great.
Think about and choose how long to bake your cookies. 50 minutes. Yum, yum, yum in my tum, tum, tum. I love baking. Let's look at what you made. This cookie looks puffy.
Ah. Now then, cookie creator. Nice. Next up is Hamster Run. I think that was the only original game that stayed. Wait a second! Those look familiar! Were those the original designs? As in, like, were those concept designs for Ruff's Three Hamsters?
Choose a challenge.
You know, I might get a copyright claim for playing the theme song, but you must hear it! It is glorious! And yeah, sure, you could look it up on YouTube, but I'll spare you the trouble.
Square blocks to help the hamster get the carrot. Tap or drag the blocks onto the board.
I will.
Tap them off to remove them.
Okay.
Tap go when you're ready to let the hamster run. Tap the pause button to
stop
tapping undo to take away all your blocks one at a time.
Okay. We did it.
That is a masterpiece of design.
We put one square down. What a masterpiece. Oh, am I kidding? Just do another level.
Pick a hamster, any. triangle as a ramp to help the hamster climb. A ramp is like a slide that joins a high place to a low one.
There we go. Let's go. Up, 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 up. There we go. Now then. Next up is Dress That Rhino. And finally, and the final one is Fish Force. What happened to the eyes?
Kids, I need your help. I'm pet sitting for Fluff the Rhino, who isn't small or a pet. And I have to keep him busy so Blossom doesn't find out. Help me dress up Fluff so he's ready for our adventures.
You know, I don't think Fluff...
Which adventure do you want to...
I don't think Fluff ever appears in the show. Also, I don't think I really watched season 5. I don't know why. Also, yeah, there's a new cast. Also, forgot to mention, there's a new cast of 6 kids for every season. So it doesn't really feel, stale. Because imagine if you were just watching the same 6 kids over and over and over. It would just get boring after a while. But whatever, that's not the case. Gotcha.
The material you think Fluff should wear for his adventure. A material is the stuff that things are made of. Feathers are what cover a bird's body. Most birds have feathers. Tap on Fluff and then...
Gotcha. Okay, that's a thing. Next up, final game, Fish Force. By the way, seasons 1 to 3, okay, by the way, there were different variations of the theme song. The theme song lyrics stayed the same, but the pictures didn't. In seasons 1 to 3, in season 1, Blossom the cat, Blossom's the name. So, in season 1, Blossom wasn't there. In seasons 2 and 3, Blossom was in the intro, I think. I'm not sure. I'll have to find out. But in season 4, the ending is different, and there's a new gag, a running gag in the intro. So just thought that was something you shouldn't know. Anywho, on to the actual game.
My toy plushie is stuck on the penguin's ice. Help me get it out. Play a level or create your... Look, my plushie is there on the...
Okay.
Slide this to choose the...
There we go.
Oh, the plushie went... Use...
Oh!
Off the wall! Try another one.
That happened.
The door slider is locked, so move the cannon to lock.
Alright, those are all the games. So, as promised, here is the great Ruff Ruffman theme song.
Very catchy. It rolls off the tongue.
Wow. Yeah, it's really short, but really great. Oh yeah, the brother was named Scruff. All right. And now then, Feast Season 4's thing. So here are the differences. And here it is. Yeah, so those were the theme songs. Pretty good, right? Really catchy. Hope it got stuck in your head. Now then, next time we do Psy Girls. See ya. How to get to.